Hello, I want to welcome Wendy Weber of Go Humanity, who will give the Heart of Humanism Awards. Wendy?
Hi, thank you. I am so excited to be here today to give our 2021 Heart of Humanism Awards. My name is Wendy Weber. As you said, I am the Programs Director at Go Humanity. I use she, her pronouns, and I am coming from you currently from the occupied land of the Tonkawa and the Sana people, which is South Central Texas, currently known as South Central Texas. To allay any confusion, until last month, Go Humanity was known as Foundation Beyond Belief. Though Foundation Beyond Belief was originally founded on a dedication to humanist philanthropy, over the years, the direct service has become more and more important to fulfilling our mission. And so the foundation part of the name didn't really tell the whole story anymore. So we have a new name, but our commitment to putting compassion into action and celebrating humanity at work is the same as always. And celebrating humanity is exactly what we're here to do today. We give the Heart of Humanism Awards every year to recognize sterling service from our GO teams, which were previously known as Beyond Belief Network teams under the old name, and to individuals who have made extraordinary contributions to compassionate humanism during the calendar year. GO teams are local teams that are putting compassion into action through community service and charitable action. Go Humanity assists teams with ideas, tips, planning, and helping find existing opportunities in their area. We also provide grants to help increase their impact. We have several awards to give, team awards to give, and two individual awards to give today, and I'm going to do the team awards first. Each team has sent a representative to virtually receive the award, and each award comes with a grant ranging from $50 to $500 to help the teams increase the impact of their work going forward. So coming to the awards, we're going to start with Rookie of the Year. This is an award that is given to the best team that joined the network during the calendar year. This year, the winner is the Humanists of Tallahassee in Florida. Devin Graham, who is one of their leaders, is here to accept the award. Humanists of Tallahassee joined our network in July 2021 and quickly became one of our most active teams. In October, they joined our food security project. We give food security project teams grants each month that support their food insecurity solutions. And Humanists of Tallahassee has joined forces with a local church, Trinity United Methodist Church, to assemble and hand out snack and hygiene packs to help people in their community that are experiencing homelessness. Beyond their weekly commitment, they still have energy for special holiday giveaways and cleanup events. We are so impressed with the Humanists of Tallahassee's impact during their first year in our network, and we know their impact will only grow from here. So thank you. The next award is the Best Photo of the Year. When the teams submit their photos with their impact reports, among other things, these become eligible for like monthly photo of the year but also this big year of the picture of the year award. This year, after we picked the finalists, our community voted to determine the picture. And this year, the winning photo comes from North Orlando's invasive plant removal event. One of their invasive plant removal events. Lucy Hale is the subject of the photo. One Saturday each month, the North Orlando event ventures into the wilderness to remove invasive plants and learn about the local ecosystem. This particular Saturday, they were working to remove invasive rosary pea and Cesar weed. So thank you for all you do and keep up the great work, North Orlando. Our next award is the Backbone Volunteer Award. This award recognizes a team that played a consistent and reliable volunteer role in a local organization. This year's team, Central Ohio United Non-Theists, also received this award last year, which underlines just how deep their commitments to these organizations are. Andrew Whitaker, the leader of their Van Buren Center program, is here to accept the award. Count has long-term regular volunteer commitments with not one, but three different organizations. Every month, Count volunteers go to the Columbus Ronald McDonald House, which provides meals and housing for families of children being treated at nearby hospitals. And since they began volunteering with them, Count volunteers have contributed over 1,800 hours, volunteer hours. They also have a monthly commitment at the Van Buren Center shelter that provides housing and meals for families and individuals experiencing homelessness. At the end of 2021, they had held a lifetime 83 events with the Van Buren Center. Starting in 2018, they started volunteering several times a month with Adaptive Sports Connection, which is a chapter of Move United, which helps people who need adaptive equipment or instruction to participate in sports. And depending on the time of the year, Count volunteers are participating in sports like cycling, kayaking, sailing, and skiing events. Count's consistent commitment to each of these organizations gives the organizations important stability to accomplish their missions. We know that they appreciate your support, and we thank you for giving it. Our next award is the Eat Sleep Volunteer Repeat Award. This is given to the GO team that submits the most events during the calendar year. This year's recipient is Atheist Community of Polk County in Florida. Keith McCullough, one of the ACPC's co-founders and directors, is here to receive the award. ACPC held an incredible 119 events in 2021. That's 36 events more than the next highest team. ACPC is another food security project team, not including all the events they did before the food security project began and launched in May 2021. ACPC distributed food to 1,348 people. Their events include street warrior events, where they deliver hot meals to people experiencing homelessness, Weekends Without Hunger, where they provide food supplies for to food insecure students at a local elementary school, and they still find time for regular cleanups of their adopted stretch of the Old Dixie Highway in Auburndale, Florida. They are making a huge difference, and we can't wait to see what you guys do going forward. To keep up the great work. Our next award is the Gimme Food and Shelter Award. This recognizes a food security project team that has outstanding contributions to causes related to homelessness, food, and water. This year, the award goes to the Food Drive in Melrose, Massachusetts. Jaina Jimenez, the Food Drive's board president, is here to accept the award. The Food Drive came to us through the Food Rescue Alliance, which is our Compassionate Impact Grant recipient last year. The Food Drive's work includes distributing rescued surplus and donated food and diverting wholesome food from landfills. And in 2021, after joining the Food Security Project, in only 3 months, they rescued over 58,000 pounds of food. Thank you for all the credible work you are doing, and good luck for the future. This year, our next award is the Brilliance and Resilience, which is a new award that we are adding this year. This award recognizes outstanding contributions to causes related to disaster aid through preparation, response, and recovery. Reginald Bien-Ami is here to receive the award on behalf of Haitian Freethinkers. You may recall that in August 2021, Haiti was hit by a 7.2 magnitude earthquake, which was right on the heels of the presidential assassination. Haitian Freethinkers is a US-based volunteer team, but because of their deep connections and including family in Haiti, they were able to raise funds and send them to local response and recovery on the ground in Haiti. This included donated funds to the Freethinkers of Haiti, who were able to distribute direct aid to vulnerable people in rural countryside who otherwise lacked access to food, water, tent, sanitation, and other basic needs. Thank you for stepping up in a particularly difficult situation, and thank you for making a difference. Our last and largest team award is the Heart Humanism at Work Award. This award is given to the team that donated the most volunteer hours during the year. This year, the team that had the most volunteer hours is Humanist Alliance Philippines International. Lucia Valenzuela is Happy's CFO and is here to receive the award. In 2021, Happy was very busy. They gave over 3,500 volunteer hours, 3,565 to be exact, while addressing a variety of concerns. They do tree plantings, educational events on topics like reproductive health and rights, responding to disasters like Typhoon Odette, with emergency supplies and food, and regularly donating bread to patients and healthcare workers addressing food insecurity that was exacerbated by the pandemic. HAPI is also a food security project team and have been using their grants to support their NutriCamp project. At these events, which are often paired with holidays, dozens of food are insecure children are fed a hot meal or given packed food. So thank you, HAPI, for all that you do. We look forward to seeing all of the impact that you're going to have in the future. Now we come to our individual awards. Our first is Outstanding Leader. This award recognizes an outstanding Go Team leader. This year, that is Danz Odhiambo, who is the president of Kenya Humanist Alliance. In 2021, Kenya Humanist Alliance held 17 events addressing food insecurity and clean water access. They take care of several orphans while also providing food for widows and other members of their community, like prisoners and people experiencing homelessness. They distribute fresh vegetables and food staples, and a lot of their food that they are able to donate and use comes from their own chicken farm and maize farm. They joined the Food Security Project in 2021 and in October, and in just the last 3 months of the year, they had 321 individual beneficiaries of their food security events. As the leader of the Kenya Humanist Alliance, Dan's leadership and dedication has been a crucial factor in accomplishing all that they were able to accomplish and will accomplish. We are thrilled to have Dan's and the Kenya Humanist Alliance in our Go Team network and community, and they are truly embodying humanism, and we can't wait to see all they will accomplish. As Dan's is in Kenya, he sent a short video to accept his award.
Greetings, comrades. I'm Danz Onyango, the president of Kenya Humanist Alliance. As an organization, we have been doing the following activities in Kenya. We are running an orphanage, which is called Danz Orphans and Widows Foundation, where we are providing shelter, meals, and clothing, including fees to the less privileged children, especially those of under tender age. We are also running a food security project, which is a project under Go Humanity, where we have distributed meals to organizations such as prisons, orphanages, and also widows and the aged people who are living in abject poverty. We are also running a project that is called Washable Sanitary Pad Project, which we initiated in the year 2020, where we are distributing washable sanitary pads to less privileged teenagers. This has really helped them and boost their morale. And this has made them to attend schools without absenteeism because of instances of menstrual periods. We are also having a program meant to rehabilitate street or homeless people, where we are counseling them and at least giving them devices like clippers, blow dryers, which enable them to start hairdressing businesses. As an organization, we have also been involved in a tree planting, basically meant to conserve our environment. We are sending sincere gratitudes and appreciation to Go Humanities for the role that they have played to Kenya Humanist Alliance, because through the grants, we have been capable of running so many activities. We also appreciate all donors that have been giving us advice and also contributing their ad and income towards our organization. I'm also extremely happy with the Heart of Humanism Award that had been nominated and have been selected to receive. I appreciate all of you.
If you want to learn more about what Dan's and Kenny Humanist Alliance is accomplishing, you can see posts about them on our Go Humanity blog, and you can also find them on Facebook. So thank you, Dan's, for all that you do. We are so impressed by all that you're able to accomplish. It's time for us to present the Heart of Humanism Award, which recognizes somebody who demonstrates humanist values. This year, the recipient is Sikivu Hutchinson. Sikivu's impact on the lives of people as she works to empower women of color to develop their own voices, self-identity, political agency, and Black feminist and humanist approaches cannot be overstated. I cannot begin to mention everything that she manages to accomplish in the time that I have. She is the founder of the Women's Leadership Project, which is a Black feminist mentoring and civic engagement program in South LA that utilizes a feminist and humanist curriculum. They spearheaded creating the hashtag Standing for Black Girls Task Force and Coalition to increase mental health education and job opportunities for Black, straight, cis, queer, and trans girls. Sikivu is investing in young women of color with education and resources, including literal funds, helping to take their share of power. It is the kind of work we want to see in the US and across the world, and we look forward to seeing what comes next for Sikivu and everyone at the Women's Leadership Project. Sikivu is not able to join us today because her play, Rock and Roll Heretic, which she wrote and directed, is running. So she sent a video to receive her award.
Hi, I'm Sikivu Hutchinson, founder of the Women's Leadership Project, which is a Black feminist mentoring, civic engagement, and advocacy program that's based in South LA. And I'm honored to be a recipient of the 2021 Heart of Humanism Award. I founded the WLP back in 2002. We started in middle schools. And the impetus for my creating WLP was really the dearth of programming that was Black feminist, that was anti-racist, that was culturally responsive, that was community-based for African-American girls, straight up and unapologetic. And we transitioned to high schools, but over the past 16 years, we have managed to develop really strong and very rich partnerships with South LA high schools. And we've done this through building a collaborative with teachers, with psychiatric social workers, with Healthy Start coordinators, with culturally responsive and social justice oriented counselors and principals and parents and other resource providers. And again, our focus is on empowering young women of color and gender expansive youth to really take ownership of their school communities by providing them with the tools to develop their own voices, to develop a sense of self-determination and identity, to promote critical consciousness about activism around race, gender, feminism, LGBTQI plus equity, and helping first generation foster, unhoused, and undocumented youth prepare for college and careers, because those youth, as we know, are more likely to be pipelined into the juvenile justice system and later on into adult prisons. WLP alum have been admitted to and graduated from colleges such as UCLA and UC Irvine, UCSD, Syracuse University, the College of Hobart and William, many of the Cal States here in California, as well as most recently, one of our graduates who came from Gardena High School and was my mentee in ninth grade, she just graduated from UCLA's Geffen Medical School in psychiatry, the first in her family to go to college, and a former foster youth. Some of our core program features and activities include peer education trainings, and we do these hands-on with youth as trainees initially, and then trainers in the classroom. And we focus really heavily on reproductive health and reproductive rights, sexual violence and sexual harassment prevention, intimate partner violence and domestic violence prevention education across genders and across sexuality. We have a Women of Color speaker series. We regularly convene WOP alum college panels to provide youth who are first generation with some guidance and with some perspective about some of the challenges that they may confront as BIPOC youth going into predominantly white institutions where there's a lot of hostility and a lot of resistance to African-American, Latinx, and Indigenous students. We also convene a semi-annual Future of Feminism conference that is spearheaded by our youth in partnership with other coalitions across LA County. We have a regular Black Feminist and LGBTQI Youth of Color Institutes that we do in South LA. The youth have initiated a virtual homegirl podcast, which is available on Spotify and other platforms. So shout out to those visionary youth who spearheaded that podcast. Please check it out. And in January of 2021, the youth spearheaded the hashtag Standing for Black Girls Coalition. These are some of the images from a couple of our rallies that we convened in 2020 and 2021. And this coalition and task force focuses on the intersection of race, gender, and sexuality in the provision of mental and reproductive health care, educational opportunities, and workforce development. One of the key program initiatives that we've implemented with the WLP and Standing for Black Girls since the pandemic has been providing youth with paid internships that are subsidized by LA County's Youth at Work program. As part of the Standing for Black Girls effort, we also initiated the Standing for Black Girls Wellness Initiative. And that initiative emerged from findings that youth concluded from a survey that the majority of African-American female identified sexual violence survivors in one of our South LA high schools were not receiving culturally responsive care, were really not receiving any care for the trauma that they experienced with sexual violence and domestic violence. And so that precipitated the creation of the Standing for Black Girls Wellness Initiative, which provides free individual counseling for LGBTQI plus straight, cis, femme, Black and BIPOC girls across LA County from 16 to 24 years old. And that is in partnership with Open Pass Counseling Center here in LA. Oftentimes, as we know, Black girl sexual violence survivors are told to just pray or trust that, quote, God has a plan as antidote to sexual abuse. And this hinders real authentic healing and treatment. And these exclusive reliance on faith remedies for healing rather than humanist alternatives can be problematic for queer and trans youth dealing with faith-based discrimination in addition to other forms of community policing like mass incarceration, or if we're talking about interpersonal relations like bullying in our school communities and push out in our school communities. Moreover, we have an issue with psychotherapists who are not trained to understand the culturally specific impact of misogynoir, adultification, and hypersexuality on Black girls. And they may not be effective in treating African-American girl clients. And so the Standing for Black Girls Youth Coalition and partners also launched, as I mentioned before, a three South LA community rallies to bring awareness about the pervasiveness of rape culture in communities of color, about the really devastating impact of domestic and intimate partner violence on Black women and girls across sexuality, as well as the devastating impact of the numbers of African-American girls that go missing and are impacted by femicide. And so again, I would like to thank the American Humanist Association and Go Humanity for this award. And there are a couple of videos that I hope you'll get an opportunity to watch that crystallize some of the activities that we have been pursuing in South LA. Thank you again.
Thank you, Sakivu, for all of the hard work that you do and the important work that you do. I know that I'm running out of time, so I'll wrap this up quickly. I do want to make sure and encourage everyone here to visit the Women's Leadership Project website at womensleadershipla.org so that you can learn more about what they are doing and donate to support their work. We will be posting those videos that she mentioned on our blog in the coming days as well. Also, you can support all of our GO teams and sponsor a specific team if you'd like on our website, gohumanity.world. And if you are a service leader and are interested in joining GO teams, please feel free to contact me. I want to thank everyone who received an award for the amazing work that you are doing. And I want to thank the American Humanist Association for giving us this platform to give the awards. And I want to thank everyone who came today to help us celebrate these extraordinary teams and extraordinary people. So thank you. And I look forward to seeing you all next year when we celebrate more humanism at work.
Thank you so much, Wendy, and congratulations to all the wonderful awardees, including Sakivu Hutchinson. And thank you for all your important work.